In my DIY video, I'm going to show you how to make this portable wall for your YouTube channels and your Zoom meetings. Before we get started though, let's talk about some of the tools that you're going to need to complete this project. Power drill is a must for this project. I have two. Skill saw is needed to cut all the wood. Now the brad nail gun is basically optional, but it can come in handy. Four steel corner brackets is for the feet. 5/16 by 2 lag screws are needed to hold down the brackets and also the caster wheels. Four corner brackets, yes, we need these to hold the wood in place. And a square, of course, to line it up and cut. The measuring tape is also needed in order for us to measure the wood. Wood clamps is good to keep the wood in place as you cut. Don't want it going back and forth. Some drill bits is needed in order for us to get the job done. 3-inch wood screws could be used for the panel and frame. And of course, the heavy-duty extension cord. You'll need at least 9 white wood studs to get started. You'll need 4/4-inch plywood or panel board of your choice. And last but not least, wood glue. Okay, so now that we talked about the accessories and the tools that we're going to need to make the wall, I'm going to take 2 feet off this beam right here and make it a 6x6 frame. And I'm going to repeat the process with the other beams. I'm going to place clamps in place so that way I'll have a nice steady flow when I cut. I don't want my beam to move right or left. And then I'm going to give that cut. Again, I'll do each beam the same way. Just repeat the process. Now, once the beams are cut, I place it on a table just to frame it out. And I don't have a wide enough table, so I'll do one section at a time. Place all my wood together. You do have the option to do this on the ground. However, my back is not equipped for that, so I'm going to go ahead and use the table. I'll place the corner clamps. This is very handy, especially when you're about to drill. You don't want no movement. You want everything to be nice and tight and snug. These are a perfect investment. I'll go ahead and drill my holes, pre-drill it, and then I'll place my screws into it. I'll repeat this process on all 4 corners. And once I do that, I'll go ahead and get ready for the next process, which would be the studs. It's important that when you make the studs, you want to cut it as accurate as possible. Repeat this process for each stud you cut. Since I'm only placing 2 studs on my frame, I'm going to place it 2 feet apart. Once your studs are properly aligned, it will be safe to drill them in. At this point, you're going to want to measure out your frame so that you know everything is measured equally. It is time to make stud supports for my frame. When it comes to cutting stud supports, you'll want to cut it as accurate as possible. This part of the project can be a little challenging and also can be time consuming. But once it's finished, you're good. Next, I'll place my 4x6 panel board on the top of the frame just to see what needs to be measured and cut. Before placing the panel back on the frame, I will put glue on the frames for extra support. Once the panel board is on the frame, it's time to use the staple gun and nail in 1-inch nails. Because of having to add additional panel board to the frame, I went ahead and doubled up on my stud support so that way it could be nailed accurately. Once your final panel board is placed and nailed on your frame, it is time to buff it out to make sure that all the splinters are gone. I am cutting two 2x4s 2 feet in length for the caster wheels. To make your wall portable, it is now time to place the wheels on the 2x4. Once you mark the wheels on where it's going to be, it's time to pre-drill the holes. It is time to tighten your caster wheels with your lag screws. You may need a ratchet wrench to give it a final tighten. Your wheels are complete. Now on to the next project. It is now time to drill the bracket to the frame. You may need to drill the lag bolt into a piece of wood plank. Repeat this process on the wheels and you are complete. Since this is a two-sided portable wall, on one side I'm just going to hang a curtain as a design. Well, as you saw, I put the curtain up. This wall on this side is designed for curtain use only, whether it's a barn door design or any type of trees or wildlife design. This is what the wall was made for. Now the other side of the wall is going to be pictures, maybe decorations hung up, whatever it is. But I made it for the purpose of my web channel, my webcast, and other things like Zoom meetings, whatever, just to make it look like a natural look in the background, which I think I'm going to enjoy. All right, and as you can see how I hung up the curtain, I actually nailed just regular nails on the beam, and so that way I could just hang up the curtain nice and smooth. I made sure that I clamped the curtain up here so that way I can get a nice fitting, and once I realized where the curtain was going to be, I kind of measured it out and started nailing. So that's what you see up there. All right, so let's do this. Okay, so there's one part of the stud, so I'm gonna go ahead and mark it right there, just like that. And then I'm gonna go this side. All right, and there's the other part of the stud. Let's go back, just to make sure, got the light right there. So we'll just go ahead and hold the picture in place. That's perfect. I just realized that my screw was a little too big for my picture frame, so instead I'm going to go ahead and hang this skull. So we got the picture here. Perfect. There we go. So now our wall, I'll have to use my leveler to make sure everything's leveled. But my wall's coming out to be perfect, you know, because when I sit down here, my chair is right here. My actual chair is going to be like right there. So if I have to move over or whatever, that's fine too. That's basically how you do it. You can add more things. I might add something on this side. I might add something on that side. Got my bear head here. It's not real. All right, check that out. So if I want to do my wildlife video, yeah, that is pretty cool. And of course, I could put some more stuff. All right, how about this? My fake deer head. Place, ooh, make sure I don't hit my fan. We bad and disastrous. There we go. Awesome. Well, as you can see, for my wildlife video programs on YouTube, I decided to keep this feature right here of a mama bear, baby bear, and my sign to my man cave. So this will be a good background to use for my web channel. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and also give me a thumbs up and share my video with your friends. So I want to thank everyone for watching my video. Until my next video, see ya.